Hello, lovely people. How are you doing today? I hope you're doing fine. Okay, so today, thank you for joining me today for this second part of this page here. I'm continuing this page, okay, in Rita Berman's book, the Europa book. Okay, so let's get started. I'm going to see how much, see how much we can do today. Okay, and I did actually pre-colored these envelopes here with a beige. Okay, is it this color? Is it eggshell? Yeah, it was eggshell. Okay, I did color the base. Okay, maybe I zoom in a little bit more. Okay, so this is the eggshell that I use. Okay, I used eggshell. Colored in the, you know, so to save time. Then I think we will, you know, give it some shading with this PC1080, just to give it some shadowing. But later I might just go in with a brown ochre or something more. Oh, there's this part I left out. Yeah. Okay. So this part here, I'm coloring in with this PC1080. You know, as this the shadow of these flowers. And then we'll go in again with this eggshell, PC140. You can use any beige color. Okay, and just blend it in. Yeah, it looks smoother. Okay, and this part here. Is this the flower? No. Okay. Right. Yes, and then just blend it back in. Maybe a tiny bit of a, you know, like this. Just a tiny bit. And behind this flower here. Okay. Now let's go in with this flower. Again, this chartreuse. Okay, and then this mineral orange. My recording, yes. And what color is this terracotta? Terracotta, I'm using terracotta PC944. And go back with mineral orange again. Okay, and then the petals, I think I'm gonna use this one, deco pink, for the outer part. Zoom in a little bit more. Okay. So this is supposed to be the back of the flower. And I always imagine this flower here, the inside part is has a bit of a green, a whitish texture. I'm going to sharpen my chartreuse. So what I do is, I would just do flicking motion, flicking, you know, just flicking, yeah, flicking motion, just flick out. Okay, and then where's my other pink? Okay, I thought I my pink out. Ah, this one. I use this blush pink, 9 to 8. Okay, blush pink for inside here. Blush pink. Okay. And this cream color, okay, cream 914. So just blend it in. Okay, blend these two in here. Cream. I like the ivory color in Holbein. It's slightly lighter than cream. Prismacolor green. Cream. Am I talking? I'll go back with this blush pink. Okay. This is actually somewhat how I colored the flowers in the England page, the London page. So use this not eggshell, cream. And bring this chartreuse and this pink together. Okay, and you can play around with this chartreuse as well. Now give it more flicking motion. Okay, maybe a little bit of a depth in this green here behind the petals. You know. And this boundary can do this one. This process red. Right? Dark purple. Okay, it doesn't matter if I don't have processed red. Yeah, I have it here. Hey, is this... No, it's mulberry. Doesn't matter. Mulberry works as well. Okay, So I have to go in with this process rate a bit. It's similar. Okay, so I go in with this mulberry or process red. I like these colors to give it this, you know, the under the petal look, the flap, the petal look. This is how I usually do the flowers with this flap, and it flips over. Okay, then we use this blush pink, right? Yes, blush pink, blend it in again, okay, and bring the color in. It's blush pink, and Hobai has a lot of nice pastel colors to play with. That's why I love Hobai so much. Well, I like a Prismacolor as well, so I mean, it's just blush pink, yeah. Use blush pink, yes. Okay, so blend it in. Okay, and if not enough, it blend too much out. Go in again with this color. Okay. Right. Yeah, you can touch up later, no problem. Okay, so that's something like that. Kelp green, just to, you know, go behind these things here. Give it a bit of a, like as if this thing is standing out. Okay, and then this chartreuse again. Okay, so this one I think orange. So color in orange. Orangey color. Cadmium orange and sunburst yellow. Okay, I think I'm gonna do sunburst yellow outside here. Sunburst yellow. Can you see this here? I'm gonna push it a bit so that you can see better. Okay, good. Yeah, sunburst yellow. Okay, sunburst yellow. And I am also going to color in sunburst yellow first, you know, just give it the base color of the same, you know, so that it looks the same, just the base. Okay, so okay, and oops, sorry, cadmium orange or yeah, mineral or cadmium orange. Okay, so I'm going to go in like this. Flicking motion again. Okay, flick out. Flick out. Okay. right. Okay, and then I use this same orange, this sunburst yellow to bring it all in. But I think I use this cream here to give it this light. Okay, so sunburst cadmium orange, sunburst yellow. Okay, so this is a sunburst yellow. Yeah. Okay. And to keep it a bit here. Go in again. Okay, and to bring it in. Let's do the yellow. This canary yellow. It's fine. Okay, just to bring it in. This part here. This part here. I'm gonna use chartreuse or ochre or chartreuse. I think because it's orange won't work, so I think I'm gonna use chartreuse. Yeah. Okay, and then apple green. Part as well. Mm-hmm. I think this part I'm gonna go in with the yellow, more yellow. Okay, so this is the flower, and this leaf here. I will go in with this dark green or Persian green, dark green. Okay, give it more depth. A bit more color, and then we shall use this spring green. We were using spring green here. Okay, spring green. Bring them all in. Yeah, and add more colors as you go if you're not too pleased with how it looks. Okay, so it's this, and then for these leaves here, this part here, I'm going in with apple green as the base color. go green first. I thought of making this green darker sort of a green. Okay, and then I'm going in with the dark green, 908. Apple green, just to blend it out a bit. Okay. Oops, dark green. Okay, and just the green again, just to blend it in. Apple green, same green. Okay, and then this one was a spring green, wasn't it? Yeah, spring green. And this part here, that's when I use the darker shade, kelp green. Okay, kelp green for this shadow part here. Or I like this forest color in this the wind like forest. Okay, forest. Okay, yeah, this kelp green here. Just bring it in. Yeah, so in here as well, behind here, the shadow. Okay, dark green, let's make dark green. Okay. Right here. Okay. Right, so this green, bring it out, blend it. Yeah, so it looks like that. And maybe this part here, use chartreuse. Where's my chartreuse? Right, yeah, there's another one more green here, so it was apple green. Okay, okay, and dark green, right. And this apple green, bring it out. Okay. And then a chartreuse here, a little bit to give it like, you know, the greenish tinge. And then this leaves here, I think we shall use this a lime peel. Okay, we shall use lime peel for this part. Okay. Some tiny leaves. The neighbors are out chatting. Right, so, and then kelp, moss green. No, I think I used kelp green. Where's my kelp green? or artichoke. Artichoke will be fine. Color in, give it some shadow because of this type of color. Okay, so and then this part, this green here I left out, so it's actually a spring green. Okay, same as this. Okay, and then I'll go in with this dark green of Persian. Dark green. Yeah, dark green. Dark green. Okay, give it a little bit of shadow. What day is today? Thursday? Okay, and then this spring green again. Bring it out. Darken it. Okay, so this one, the berries here, I think I'm going to use berries, tiny berries there. I'm going to use poppy red. Yeah, it's visible. Okay, and then we shall do this one. I think this one we shall do poppy red. I like poppy red. Okay, we shall color in with poppy red. Okay, this is the base color, and then we shall go in with this one, raspberry at the bottom. Okay, raspberry at the bottom, and then inside here we go give a bit of raspberry, a little bit hue shading with a raspberry, and then go back with this poppy red again. Yeah, and then this green part here, we shall give it this green here. And then go in with the apple green. And dark, slightly darker green. Okay. Alright. See, so, and in this part here, all these parts, yellow. What yellow? I'm using canary yellow. Okay, and then chartreuse. Where's my chartreuse? It's under the... was here a minute ago. Yeah. Okay. This part. And then... this sunburst orange to give it a little bit of, you know... make it more, a bit more interesting, this part. Okay. So, this one, what is this? I think I'm gonna color it with moss green. Moss green. I'm gonna color it with moss green. I think these are just like, you know, decorative sort of moss green, and then I think this one, and then lime peel. Okay, lime peel. Right, and then this part here, same thing. This is this kelp green, moss green. Okay, moss green. Okay. Right. So, and lime peel again. Not just to blend it in. Yeah, I think it looks grand. Okay, so it's gone past 30 minutes. It takes a long time to actually get this done. So, I think I'm going to stop here for today. If you want to see me finishing up this part, do let me know in the comments, or else I'm just going to leave it. Okay, so thank you for joining me again today. I shall see you next time. All right. Don't forget to give me a cheeky thumbs up if you have followed me to this end and you like the video. And take care and happy coloring. Bye-bye.